Good morning. Today we are going to discuss one of the exciting assignment from class 8 and the topic the world of microorganisms part 1. So let us discuss one by one question. What type of microorganisms can be observed in the pond water? So what are the organisms generally we used to see that here in the pond water? Majorly algae and protozoans. So protozoans and algae. So what are these algae? For example, Chlamydomonas, Spirogyra, so when we are going for that of protozoans, amoeba, paramecium. So these are the examples of this protozoans and the algae which we can find that in the pond water. Let us go for that of next question. The next question, write an activity to observe that a fungi. So here the fungi which is we used to see that generally like normal, which is bread mold. How can we grow that bread mold is, for example, if you take that the bread piece of a bread, sprinkle that water on it and put it in the zip bag, polythene bag, and put it in that dark place. So after this, after few days, as we can find that some black powdery like substances on the bread. So that we are going to here, that fungi we are going to find out with an activity. So the first, every activity which is consisting of that, aim, materials required, procedure, and observation, result, and precautions are also we have to do. Here, before the procedure, we need to check this precautions and comes to that of our aim. Our aim is to observe that a fungi, Rhizopus. Usually the fungi, bread mold, scientific name is Rhizopus. So materials required here. Materials required, slice of the bread, which is with that of black spoiled bread, just now as we have discussed, and the toothpick. And the next one is cover slip microscope to observe. The next one, procedure. So we have to take that spoiled part on the slide and with the help of that needle, then add a drop of water on the slide. So we have to take on the slide that black color powdery like substances. So black color powdery like substances with the help of the needle, then as we need to go for the top, put a drop of water. So drop of water we have to add and then observe it, observe under the microscope. So when you are observing that, it's just having that here, you can find here the structure of this Rhizopus. So what do we can see here, what we can find here? So with that of this knob-like structure is called as sporangium, which is bearing that is spores. So here roots like structure, we can find that a roots like structure. So here rhizoids, with the help of this only it can penetrate to that of other place of the bread. Then here you can find here the color which is showing here, the spreading part, that is hyphae. So this is hyphae. So all the spread it over there. So this is what about the rhizopus, which is present bread mold. Okay. So when you are going for that of observation, the fungi which is known as rhizopus have been observed. Result. So rhizopus can be seen which is growing on the bread, spoiled bread, as we can see that on that particular areas which has been changed to that black color substances, that is nothing but your rhizopus. Then precautions. So do not eat and smell that bread. whenever we are doing that an experiment, we should not smell it or else we should not touch that to taste. Then use that toothpicks only. We should not use that our hands to take that a sample. Don't touch directly with the hands. So directly if we are taking here, it may cause us that any infections like. And we after doing of this experiment, we have to wash our hands. That's all for this assignment. Thank you.